keeping in touch via email with NVDA.
One of the very common things that people like to do with their computers is keep in touch via email. There is a free program that can be used for doing this. The program is called Thunderbird. The reason we're choosing Thunderbird is that it is very compatible with NVDA and other screen readers. Before you install Thunderbird, you will need to have an email account already set up. Two very common places to get email accounts, which are free, are gmail.com and outlook.com. We have a Gmail account set up that we're going to use for this video. One very popular activity when using a computer is to send email to family and friends. When you send an email, you are sending a letter to somebody, but you are using the computer instead of the normal paper post. In order to send and receive email, you need to have an email account. We are going to be using an email account from a service called Gmail, which you can get to by going to www.gmail.com to set up your email address. Once you have that done, the easiest way to send email and read your email, if you're using a screen reader, is to use an email program like Mozilla Thunderbird. We are using Thunderbird because it tends to be the easiest to use for somebody using a screen reader, and it is also free. If you own a copy of Microsoft Office, you may also have a program on your computer called Microsoft Outlook. This program can also be used to send and receive email. Thunderbird can be downloaded from the following webpage: www.mozilla, and that's mozilla.org/Thunderbird, Thunderbird. So we're now in Mozilla Thunderbird, and we have a list of emails that we have received. So I'm just going to use the up and down arrow to move through this list, and you'll be able to hear NVDA read the messages.
Toolbar, table, fill, take the best of three tips to get the most out of Gmail. Gmail team 2/17/2015 10:09 a.m. row 1 of 4 level 1. The best of Gmail, wherever you are on Red. Gmail team 2/17/2015 10:09 a.m. row 2 of 4 level 1. Stay more organized with Gmail's inbox on Red. Gmail team 2/17/2015 10:09 a.m. row 3 of 4 level 1. Hello on Red. Jason Fair 9:42 a.m. row 4 of 4 level 1.
Okay, so what I'm hearing there, the first thing that I'm hearing is the subject of the email. The second thing I'm hearing is it's telling me if that message is read or if it's unread. It says unread. And then I'm also hearing the person, the name of the person that it was sent from, and then the date and time, or if it was just sent today, just the time that it was sent. So I've got a few messages in here because this is a new Gmail account. They send you a couple of messages just saying, you know, welcome to Gmail, and here are all the things you can do with it. But I've got this other message from that says hello.
Hello on Red. Jason Fair 9:42 a.m. row 4 of 4 level 1.
So what if I want to read this, I can just press enter.
Hello Mozilla Thunderbird. Hello Mozilla Thunderbird. Hello. Hello, this is a test message. Have a wonderful day. Privacy disclaimer, Franz.
Okay, so then I can just press control to stop that reading if I don't want to read the whole message. So now I can use the up and down arrow just as I did in the document before to read through this if I want to.
Blank. Hello, this is a test message. Blank. Privacy disclaimer, Francais a grave swiver.
Okay, so it's saying it's trying to read the French message as English because it doesn't know it's French. That can happen. So if I want to reply to this message, I can press Control R, and that will bring up a screen that allows me to reply to that message.
Right, hello. About blank document editable. Blank. About blank document editable. Blank.
Okay. So now I'm in a place where I can just type a reply. I'm going to type, thank you for your email.
T.
H A N K space Y O U space O R space Y O E R space E dash A L dot space.
And then I'm just going to press enter. And then to send the message, there's a shortcut key to send the message, and that's Control Enter.
Send message dialog. Are you sure you are ready to send this message? Send button.
Okay, so I'm on the send button, so I can just press enter.
Sending messagery. Hello, dialog. Hello, Mozilla Thunderbird.
Okay, and off it goes. So that message is now sent. So that's replying to somebody that's already sent me a message. What if I wanted to send a message to somebody that I'm not replying to? I just want to create a new message. What I can do is press Control N, as in new, to create a new message.
Right, no subject. About blank document editable.
Okay, so I'm gonna send this message to myself.
Row 1, column 2. 2, combo box collapsed. Edit as autocomplete. Blank.
Okay, now I did give a lot of speech there. Again, you can press Control if you want to stop it. To send a new message, after I press Control N, it's going to ask who I want to send this to. So we're just going to use the address 123 at gmail.com.
G-A-I-L dot C-O-M.
And then if I press Tab.
Subject, edit, blank.
So it's asking what the subject of my message is. We're just going to say hello.
E-L-L-O. About blank document editable. Blank.
Okay, so then I press Tab again, and now we're in the area where I can type the text of my message. I'm just going to say, how are you today?
H-O-W space A-R-E space Y-O-U space T-O-D-A-Y question.
And then the same as replying, I would just press Control Enter to send it.
Send message dialog. Are you sure you are ready to send this message? Send button.
And that would send the message.
CNIB, seeing beyond vision loss. This video has been made possible thanks to an educational grant from Novartis Pharmaceuticals Canada Incorporated.